give you some emo history. I earlier made a video about punk, and punk actually is the grandfather of emo, and that was my part one. But today I want to talk about hardcore punk, because after punk, hardcore punk evolved, and I think hardcore punk is chapter number 2, and today we're going to talk about the hardcore punk era of the emo history. I already told you a couple times in other videos that hardcore punk is the direct ancestor of emo, so that's why I think it's really important to know what hardcore punk is if you're an emo, and that's why I'm going to make this video. What exactly is hardcore punk? Well, hardcore punk is a subgenre of punk, of course, and it's a music style that was formed in the end of the 70s. Hardcore punk is, like the name already says, a harder style of punk, so it's a really hard style of punk. And it also has its own scene and fan base, and that's why hardcore punk has also an own subculture, and I'm going to explain you what subculture that is. Hardcore punk formed in the end of the 70s in the United States. And like I said in part 1 of my emo history videos, punks had their own political statements, and they wanted to show their thoughts, and they were rebelling against the bigger ideologies. The punks were known for using a lot of alcohol and drugs and for their behaviors, and some punks didn't like these behaviors, because how can they ever take be serious by other people and bigger ideologies? How could they ever be taken seriously if they were always drunk or high? And they will never be taken seriously. So some punks did start to rebel against the punks, and they started to create their own group, and they still saw themselves as punks, but they were not interested anymore in the normal 70s punk. And this all came up with a new music style named hardcore punk, and that's where the group of people belong to. It's not sure yet where the term hardcore is coming from, but what most people do agree is that the term hardcore is coming from the album Hardcore 81 from the hardcore punk band DOA. So probably the term hardcore is coming from that album. The music itself is inspired by earlier proto-punk bands and New York punk. New York punk was a harder style of punk rock, and that's what inspired hardcore punk. And hardcore punk is also a very harder style of punk, and it's really hard and really fast. So, and the lyrics about hardcore punk is like normal punk bands. It's about politics and their subculture itself. That's where the lyrics often are about. But hardcore punk had also its own fan base and even its own subculture. Like I already told you in this video, people that did like hardcore punk were rebelling against the punk, and they didn't like the alcohol and drug behaviors of the punk, so they rebelled against this, and that's how Straight Edge formed. So a lot of people that belong to the fanbase scene of hardcore punk called themselves straight edgers, and they didn't smoke and they didn't use drugs and they didn't drink, and this all to rebel against these behaviors. And they showed this by drawing a cross on their hands with tape or paint. They just were punks without alcohol and drugs, but they had the same thoughts and political statements as normal punks. This is a subculture called straight edge, and it's a really interesting subculture and also the ancestor of emo. So if you want to hear more about straight edge, then I already did make a video about it earlier, so if you want to know more about it, then check out that video. Hardcore punk bands wanted to be independent from the rest of the people, so they had independent record labels and they were really focused on do-it-yourself. They had a strong us feeling, and the bands made their own magazines, their own records, and made their own leaflets and organized their own shows. So that was a lifestyle of hardcore punk. Some people even think the term hardcore is used to describe, because the hardcore shows were always really hardcore, and they really were. They were really rude and hard. They liked to stage dive, and they also did read, they did invent the mosh pit, and they were pushing each other but with respect. So these shows were really hardcore, and yeah, maybe the term is coming from that. After hardcore punk, a lot of subgenres formed, like New York hardcore, metalcore or mathcore, and some hardcore punk bands started to write more emotional and personal lyrics instead of political lyrics, and this later started to be called emotional hardcore, and that's how emo formed. But I will tell you that story in a next video. Well, this was my new chapter of the emo history. I hope you think it's interesting. Like my video and bye!